Hello. GIII, no hits, or not no hits, but no healing. Part four, I believe. So, off camera again, I did progress the story. Basically, to the end of that menu stuff, we visited Schmidt and brought in the limb food and got a plane and all that. Should be available in the morning after returning to the boat. But first, we're gonna do a little shopping. I haven't actually checked the shops or anything, so I'm not really sure what's available right now, but we'll see. If we don't have it, you don't want it. I'm gonna sell this miracle elixir. It sells for a lot, and we should really not need it. Probably come back, but let's check the magic and skill shops first. Thank you. I figure we might as well take off life up, since this is a basically minimal hit challenge anyway. A little more risk in the name of better offensive is always good. I heard recently that equipping a wind mana egg will actually boost the power of whirlwind, and fire mana egg will boost the power of all special moves. I don't know if that's true, it would make sense, but I never thought of it. It's probably true. I don't know how it slipped over my head. Thank you. That should be sufficient setup. So, to my recollection, there aren't any bosses, except for the Xi Sigma in Arcriff, until probably the end of Disc 1. Dragon Valley doesn't have a boss. And Arcriff's boss is at the beginning there, or I guess the midway point, kinda. So we're mostly going to be facing ordinary enemies until we're finished up with Disc 1. And then there are quite a few bosses in Disc 2. I've been kind of thinking about removing most of the armor from the run. Not 100% sure on that, but most enemies aren't dealing a whole lot of damage right now. So the hits we do take aren't that impactful. Sorry, my charger is hardly working on my phone. Gotta get that fixed. Okay, should be fine. Got a really crappy extension cord. That is actually an exceptional mule scene.
Thank you.
And we've got a plane for like 2 minutes. Did the black bars at the top and bottom fade in, slide in? They look cool. The duo barrel roll button doesn't work here. Alright, short dungeon time, and then Arcriff. So, like, we do have some armor equipped. We could just take it off. I'll try that for now. Going against the actual bosses later, that may not really be a viable option. Are they weak to fire? Is this gonna hit the one behind? Please.
Take this!
Yes!
It also... Either these guys are weak to normal non-elemental damage, which would not be the case because Yuki is using fire, or they're weak to fire, in which case... In which case, the impact damage from Blazestorm is also elemental, which is kind of funny. If he'd attacked there, he would have just been interrupted. Defending to a different location still leaves you in a state that's able to sway. So he dodged and countered because he has a pretty good dodge chance. Either Alcina's chance is quite poor, or I'm just getting unlucky. Question mark? Burnstrike isn't dealing improved damage.
I'm a pilot. I don't have time for this.
I mean, she'll totally be revived at some point along the way. There's a save here before the boss. I mean, kind of boss. It might actually be difficult. Not counting on it though. There actually are a couple shots here. Alfina still dead as a doorknob. There are literally no offensive options available here that weren't available at Mandy. Maybe Tremor? Well, those stars were pointless. Yuki, watch out, there's a pillar! You're gonna walk into the pillar! Oh my god, he has his AirPods in, he can't hear us. Never super paid attention to the journal entry that Emilius was entering. Alright, I'm back. Did the cutscene end without me? Nope, just on time. Yuki always wakes up late. This is a running gag. Guys, I don't remember where the exit is. You can always count on NPCs. That fight solo would probably be a little harder. So do we want the wind ranked different from Anode? Or no? Let's see how this goes.
Okay.
Oh god.
Come on!
I'll be fine.
That's okay!
Sorry, this might hurt.
That was actually really strong.
All right, we did it!
Loli kills the other. Okay, that fight is fine. With a grenade. Let's try it once more without a grenade. Nope. Could have avoided that.
Come on! Not so bad! Here I go!
Oh, oops.
Come on!
Bad place.
Eat this! Come on!
I'll be fine.
Back in a minute, gotta go grab something from the oven. Blueberry muffins and turnover thingies. Gonna be good.
This'll be more than a little frostbite!
Rip you, Pew. He lived.
I'll be fine.
She's fine. Let's see about trying that again.
Release your power!
No. Thankfully, countering a counterattack does not count as a counterattack. A counter. The plus 30% thing. Terminology.
All right, we did it.
That was a big meter. All right, now onto the real dungeon. I'm gonna heal here, but let's try to get through most of the dungeon without healing between battles if possible. I will take those items for the gold, though. Thank you. Ooh, hold on. Since this place is dark. Very scary stuff. Caller multiply? Caller add? Wow, that looks awful. Okay, fine, I guess color multiply was all I needed. Dark mode. And here's the dungeon, capital D. What I just picked up. Poison amulet, cool. Oh God. Yuki, you're supposed to dodge!
We did it!
Lightning Stone? Wait, I could use a grenade. I kinda doubt a grenade would have been quick enough, even with item mastery.
Alright! We did it!
And other bombs probably wouldn't have done enough damage to kill. Wow! I thought that's the one Yuki was targeting, but clearly not.
Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, divine comet, bringer of light, illuminate the darkness!
Nice. Pretty sure you could have done something about that.
Hear me, Blade. Release your power!
Just on time.
Oh, divine comet, bringer of light, illuminate the darkness! I'm sorry, we had no choice.
Finally. Thank God that was an ambush. Lol. He actually had a lot of iframes there. No, wrong button, wrong button, wrong button.
Turn things around, I hope.
That's a really good voice line.
I'm sorry, we had no choice.
She's fine. Oh God.
Burn strike!
See? He's fine.
All right! We did it!
Couldn't be better, Ash. Easy. We were never in any danger. Handholding. Somehow I figured this wasn't going to be a recover sphere. Tell them Griff is dead, why? Like, I'm gonna be honest, Alfina, you were there. I think you can figure this out. Revival gem is a kind of healing item, it is not allowed.
Never catch us now!
We're fine. I think that's everything. Some doubts about our overall survivability, but let's see. Let's try. Let's find. Everything's fine.
Of course.
See.
A blade of light.
No problem.
Strike at our enemies. Ha! I'm sorry. We had no choice.
See, we're fine.
Eat this.
Justified.
Hey, were they even trying?
A little faster, guys.
Hey, were they even trying?
Can we survive sheep? Yuki can't. Jesus Christ, that was close. Sometimes. Oh my god, this could actually be close. Never mind, it's fine.
I feel a little guilty.
Huh! noticed that his blade gets, like, that cool blue effect around it, and then it goes back to red after. So I think I'm specifically showing the element that he's using, which is pretty neat. Because it only turns white when he actually swings it around. When he's charging up the move, it's still flaming. Face the strategy. Or it could just miss.
More than a little frostbite.
I love that Baba has such a huge charge of time, as though it's this crazy powerful move. Good. These sell for about 45,000 apiece. Blueberry muffins are good. Did the lizard guys at the start just not respawn? Or were there not any? Oh well. Made it to the plane. I remembered. There's another boss. Completely forgot about this part of the game. Oops. Double Minotaurs with Ulf. That said, I'm saving that for the next episode. That's it for this time. Thanks for watching.